Hey guys, what is up? Eric Merced here, and we have a new tutorial. This is a tutorial that I have been thinking about making for quite a while. And basically, this tutorial addresses the problem of bringing in an image that you've worked on traditionally and inked traditionally and bringing it into Procreate to color. I've seen a few artists that I follow. They will usually ink an image traditionally and bring it into Procreate to color it afterwards. And there are a lot of ways that it can be done, but I'm going to show you a neat trick using Medibang Paint to bring in your image into Procreate for coloring. And as you're going to see in the tutorial, what we're going to do with Medibang Paint is we're going to separate the line art the way we would in a Photoshop or any other desktop app. Currently, this can't be done within Procreate, so we're going to use Medibang Paint to achieve our goal. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to make sure that we've imported the image that we want to use, that we want to color, into our Photos app, and this is the image in question. So once that's done, we're going to go ahead and open up Medibang Paint. So once Medibang Paint is loaded up, we want to tap on the import button and then on the browse and import, and that will open up the Photos browser, and there we can tap on the image that we want to import. So here's where things start to get interesting, because once you import an image like this one, Medibang Paint has this hidden feature which offers to extract all of the lines from the image, as we're about to see. So we have two choices here. We can extract lines, or we can choose not to extract the line art. Our goal here is to separate the black from the white on the page, so we're going to go ahead and tap on extract lines. Once we do that, we're going to get this new window, and here we can adjust the shadow, the halftones, and the highlight of the image. My experience with this is that 99% of the time that I've imported black and white images, I've rarely have to have mess with this. Medibang Paint does a really good job of detecting the blacks from the white on the page. Where we get into muddy territory is when you try to import a sketch or something with a little bit of more color. Then you're going to have to go in there and adjust the sliders in order to get the image to look as close as possible to the original image. It isn't a perfect solution, but it really is close to perfection, to be honest. So I'm going to leave this image as is, because really I don't see any reason to mess with the sliders here. And I'm going to go ahead and tap on Done in the upper right hand corner. The next dialog that you will get after pressing Done is that Medibang will ask you if you want to preserve the line art layer. You want to protect it or you don't want to protect it. This is basically just asking you, once this art is imported into its own layer, do you want to lock the layer or do you want to keep it unlocked? This really doesn't matter at the moment, so we're just going to go ahead and tap on Don't Protect. And that's pretty much it. Medibang Paint has separated the line art from the white page, and I'm going to show you by creating a color layer here and bringing it to the bottom. I'm going to go ahead and fill that color layer with red. Let's see if I got the settings correct here. And you can see we don't see any of the white here, because Medibang Paint just kept all of the black lines. There's a couple of things you need to keep in mind when you work in this method. It's basically that if you're going to import an image, make sure it is a high resolution image. Anything 350 DPIs, up to 350 DPIs is pretty good to bring it in. Make sure it's a PNG file, because PNG files are recognized by iOS and they maintain the higher quality. So that way when you're zooming in to the image in Procreate, you really won't see much blurriness. So now the next step after importing the art and Medibang separates the line art is to export this line art into Procreate. So in order to export this to Procreate, we're going to go ahead and save the file. Let's tap on the hamburger menu up on the upper left-hand corner and choose Save, and we'll choose New Save. Once it's saved, let's close out this file by returning to the gallery, tapping on Internal to go to our gallery, and tapping on the Share menu. We can export this as a PNG with transparency, but because Procreate now officially has PSD support, we're going to tap on PSD instead. Once Medibang creates our file, in the Share menu, we're going to choose Add to Procreate. And what Medibang will do is we'll send that PSD file over to Procreate. So we can go ahead and close out Medibang and open up Procreate. And once we do that, Procreate will import the PSD file from Medibang. So here we can see by opening the layers palette, we can see that Medibang did its job in separating the line art from the white. And let's just go ahead and show that even further by changing the color of our background. And as you can see, the line art is on a separate layer of its own. Now we can easily color our art without needing to resort to using layer modes like multiply. There's a couple of reasons why you would want to do this. It's the best practice when coloring in apps like Photoshop, and this is a neat way to bring that feature over into Procreate. But one of the reasons why you can do this is because now that your line art is separated into its own layer, you can do things like locking transparency and changing the line color, which is called color holes. And just to show you here real quick, I can go ahead and change the line art color without affecting any of the white area in the image. So you can do things like that by taking this approach and using Medibang Paint as a bridge to get your line art separated from the whites so that you can have that line art in a separate layer of its own. So thanks for watching this video. If you have any questions or comments, make sure to leave them in the comments section below. I will try to get to as much comments as I can. And as always, you can show your support by clicking or tapping on that like button. I will see you all in the next video. Until then, stay creative and create great things. God bless you all.